it would be sheer madness if I put a game I would be doing last, not last, in the schedule. Alright. Here's some anime. Anime for y'all. Alright, I got my FAQ open off to the side in case I get lost. We're off to the photosphere, is what we're doing now in this part of the story. Yeah, Wild Arms is still going. Hey, guess what? We're not even halfway done through Wild Arms. Apparently, we are right before the midway point in the game. It's at the end of the dungeon I'm going to next. But luckily, after this dungeon, I'll have access to the better magic, and I can get the encounter down magic. Hey, thank you, Boris. I appreciate it. But we're probably only going to do 2 hours, maybe, of this. And then we'll switch to Star Wars. Because I'm pretty sure Star Wars is also not... I don't think Star Wars is going to be single-sitting either. Because I watched Caveman do some of it, and... Oh man, that game is long and it's rough. So that one's also going to be quite the adventure. Alright, there's our single 480i screen in the entire game, and it's got a switch back. Alright, so 1142, probably the last one. Yep, the Phantom Menace. Alright. We're gonna be practically pod racing soon. Alright, where's my giant robot? Okay, so... What is this? Oh. Alright, I have a map, apparently. Or I should have a map somewhere. Alright, so... We're headed up to the photosphere, which I think is north of here. Because there's a shield around the photosphere, and our giant robot got upgraded so it can break through the shield now. Yeah, I played through the PC version of Phantom Menace when it came out. And yeah, that game is fucking rough. Almost forgot something important here. Earth Golem. One of the few PlayStation games. Alright. So this... Alright, I figured that would happen. I had to test it, though. Okay, so I probably have to bomb... those things. The red things. Hey, alright. Ambushed, great. No idea what you're supposed to do. Yeah, that's gonna be a thing in Phantom Menace. Oh man, I can tell this area can be pretty good. Oh my god, is that gonna confuse? How long speedrun of Wild Arms is? It's like an hour and 40 minutes, I think. If you do exclamation mark X, or exclamation mark S, and then Wild Arms in chat, my bot will spit out some links for you. And one of the links is to the speedrun page for this. No one would ever speedrun it. Like, 8 people speedrun Wild Arms. This is like the Super Mario 64 of PS1 RPGs. Alright. Please, just run. Alright, maybe I should actually fight these enemies. Oh, good. Silenced. Alright. I want to at least escape from this. The speedrun strats for this is to, like, use arbitrary code execution to skip to the end of the game. Which, even by my standards, that is a bit much. Well, look, PS Explosion is not, hey, let's speedrun every single game. It's, hey, let's plan. And if it's a sub-pick, I need to do my best to get through it. Because, let's be clear, if I was going to drop this game and stop playing, I would have dropped it a while ago. A long while ago. Yeah, this is... Any game that ends in a zero... with a number up there is a subscriber thing. Alright, let's try running from this. This looks runnable. Oh yeah, I am never playing a Rugrats game. Ever again, ever. Alright, Cat Wizard. It'd be great if I could dupe an item that lets me escape from battles or something. But that would be asking too much. Huh. I must get another item here. Oh, I dropped down. Okay. That would be how you do this. Can I counter skip the beginning? Yeah, I'd be okay with that. Though from what I've heard, Wild Arms 3 is really good. Like, it's actually good, unlike this. By all accounts, Wild Arms, like, even 2 is good, so I'll be okay with those. Is that what? Programming job. Nice. Congrats on new job. It's no Chrono Trigger, but what is? Have you heard of a game called the Grandstream Saga? A game that is better than Chrono Trigger. Alright, let me see if I can start running. Oh man, it finally let me run. Thank you, game. Agile Apple, oh man. Oh. Wait, does that? That's just for red. Okay, I don't think that does anything. Robo Samurai, judging from the noises it makes, it appears to be a cat. So yes. What? Oh man, that Doom Door sound effect. I like the running away mechanic, as frustrating as it can be. I do like there's at least some suspense to it. Guys, we're just going to. I already know this is not a runnable fight. Alright, that animation looks dumb every time. Attack 25, auto attack orbs, single target. Yo, rocket launcher's group. Shit, I should have been using that. The project ended in failure. But they can't all work. That would be weird if they did. I got really far in implementing it, and then some voltage probably went where it shouldn't have, and it damaged either my 3D controller or it damaged the controller port on the Saturn. I'm not sure which. The digital controls work fine, the buttons work fine. The problem is on the 3D controller, it thinks it's constantly holding down on the analog stick, which is obviously not what it's supposed to do. So that controller I have is probably a goner in terms of using it as an analog controller. But I'm actually kind of okay with that, because I really like the 3D controller, and I could just use that one as a digital controller. And then I'll likely end up ordering another 3D controller for analog stuff. I'm probably going to order a Japanese one, just because they look cooler. They're painted white and they have colored buttons on them, rather than just like the straight matte black that the US ones are. They're about the same price too, so might as well. A bad connection? I'm pretty sure it's not a bad connection, because the controller is still busted when I don't have it plugged into the Arduino. Which is how I knew it was busted. And unfortunately, I can't determine if it's the Saturn or the controller, because my USB to Saturn thing that I already have doesn't support the analog controller. Alright, so we got the tier. I I don't do the splice on the controller, I do it on an extension cord. Because if I did it on the controller, I would have to redo the... the wiring for every single controller. And that's... that is not strats. That's the opposite of strats. Like, I do the same thing here for the PlayStation version. I have an extension cord that I cut in half, and then whenever I need to change a controller, I just plug in the controller into that extension cable. And no modifications are needed to the individual controllers. Yeah, it's a better solution in some ways. It just ends up being more work because you have to have your code account for whatever weird protocols the controller signals put out. If you did direct wiring to the controller PCB, then that's in a lot of cases much simpler, but not in every case. Like Dreamcast, for example. I tried to do direct wiring to the PCB on the Dreamcast controller, and the sensors for the analog triggers and analog sticks do not like being wired to. They wouldn't give out the power signals. Though now that I think about it, with what I learned last night about how Sega does their wiring, I think I know how to get around that now. So I might be able to make the direct Dreamcast controller capture work. Still won't be able to do VMU. Oh well. I did check stuff with the multimeter. I don't think it was a short though. I think just something got fucked up. Yeah, I was fairly thorough with my checking. But I think it's just something somewhere went awry that who knows what it was. And I'm just not gonna bother with that anymore. Because that's going to get expensive if I have to keep buying Saturn controllers. Or worse, Saturn systems. Oh good, she got confused. Great. Oh great. Alright. Cool. Alright, I think I'm just going to have to run every turn now. Yeah, the knowledge that I gained is don't mess around with Saturn stuff. Oh my god. Alright, one of those two needs to wake up. Or I need to successfully run. Oh my god. It's snowing. Let's go. Alright. Still sleeping. Okay, she's not confused anymore. Okay. Thank you. she silenced now? Of course. Of course. Alright, well, maybe now I can run. Of course not. How silly of me. Alright, well they're awake now. Room not nice and cool now? It's still hot. It's still really hot. It's gonna continue to be super hot until probably December. Book your silence. Alright, so where do I use that teardrop? There's like a room that was filled with alarm stuff. It's over here? Oh, let's turn the bomb, okay. Alright, never know when a boss is gonna show up. For some P. Cybergeist. Oh, man. And those are vampires, apparently. At L. I have a feeling the boss is probably close. AC doesn't do anything here. Like, my AC typically is on. Just the heat production from all the stuff in here overpowers any air conditioning I can throw at it. Guessing I can't run from this. Well, it's not necessarily the machines that are creating the heat. It's the TV / monitors and all that, which I can't put in another room unless I have some weird set of mirrors or something, like I was in Egypt. What was that I picked up? Yeah, I bet being in a smallish room with a bunch of arcade shit is no fun in the heat department either. It's been 1,000 years. What? Where did this 1,000-year-old golem stuff come from? Alright. Well, let's give it some rocket launcher. And then give it some slash ray. Yeah, I don't have, a temperature gauge in here. That's actually on my to-do list, is to get, like, a five... Oh, shit. Is to get, like, a $5 thermometer. This is... going swimmingly. Do I have anything to... I have nothing to cure sleep. If anything sold a cure for sleep, I would have definitely bought some, so that's great. Alright, let's keep Rudy alive, I guess. Probably gonna kill Jack here. Unless sleep misses. This is looking like a rip. Well. Alright. If it worked for the sleep effect, this would be fine. Okay. Do I have any equipment that I could use to deal with this? Elify. That's for disease and poison. Do you have anything? Nothing for better sorcery. Well... yeah, I've hardly picked up any hats in this entire game. Alright, so... can I duplicate anything that would make this... Thank you. Like an AoE heal would be great. But I don't think I have anything remotely like that. I think I might have to leave the dungeon and go probably go make a spell to deal with sleep or something. I think that's probably my only option, because I don't see not getting wrecked here over and over again. I don't think there's going to be any other way to deal with this fight otherwise. Alright. There's apparently an ability or a spell or something. Okay, there's a spell. Cecilia can get a spell called Awaken, which automatically wakes up people if they fall asleep. But you need to have the spell, so guess what? We're gonna go get that spell. So we're gonna leave the dungeon and go get that one spell, and that should trivialize this fight. This way. Apparently I should be level 30. Something for this as well. That ain't happening. Alright. Hopefully this town even has a magic shop. There it is. Alright. We needed spells anyways, I guess. Okay, absorb magic. Wake from sleep, okay. Alright, awaken. So that should trivialize all that. And sure, let's just get this. Earth magic. Use blind. Seems useful. Get that. And then the wind and thunder, and then we will move on. Earth, wind, thunder. What's the story? Golems? Demons? Alright. That should be all we need. Yeah, magical aliens, also demons. Yeah, I could dupe the Crustgraphs, but I don't think I really need all the spells. Yeah, I totally can do Crustgraphs. Anything that appears in your inventory during battles, you can dupe. Yeah, being softlocked inside of foot races. Pretty good. Alright. Hey, remember the first part of this dungeon? Let's do it again. Because it was so much fun the first time. Luckily, I don't have to do all this again. Alright, please let me know. Since we're gonna be in this fight anyways, let's dupe the Mega Berry. Yeah, that's pretty much every single dungeon, boys. This might... Okay, good. Good thing I didn't kill, because that would have wasted my, my one Mega Healing Berry. Alright, so I should have 255 Mega Berries now. That's how you dupe items. Yeah. We got 255 of those. I don't think I really need to dupe anything else. Crazy thing is, we've been getting all these encounters, but apparently I'm still underleveled. We've been getting a shitload of encounters, I've been fighting most of them, and we're still underleveled by a fair amount. You use an item for the first two characters, and then when you get to the third character, you need to swap the item that you used with an item that you didn't. Or with the item that you want to duplicate. So it's throwaway item, and then swap in the duplicated item with the throwaway item in the inventory slot, and that duplicates it as Wild Arms. I didn't need to go here. I got lost already. This isn't even a big dungeon, and I got lost already. Oh, the other important thing for item duping is that the item that you're duping has to only have one of them in the stack. That's the other important thing to this dupe.
Oh,
Yeah, you can't just dupe stuff willy-nilly, but it's easy enough to just sell the thing that you're duping to get it down to one. So it's not, like, super hard to do. Yeah, it's a really easy way to dupe money, or to get money. Alright. Which of these cures whatever he has? It's like flash is what I need to cure. Cure the kind of not great StarCraft 2 player status effect. Yeah, it's welcome. Alright, so now that we have that awakened spell, we should not be getting wrecked as hard by the boss here. In theory. It appears that there aren't encounters here, besides these searchlight ones, which is nice. Alright. Let's make sure. Got bullets. I guess I could have powered up that single target thing while I was in town, but oh well. Too late now. Okay, so for this, caster needs to cast Awaken immediately. Hopefully she can cast it before this happens. I also don't know if I need to keep recasting it. So apparently that spell will automatically awaken the party. Okay. I don't know if I have to recast it though. We'll see. This will be our experiment. Alright, damage. Okay, so here we go. Is the alarm clock gonna show up? Alright, good. Good. Alright. We got the party heal themselves in this turn. So this battle appears to be kind of trivial if you have the Awakened spell. If you don't have it, then you just get completely wrecked. So this is like the equivalent of a gear check boss, I guess. So instead of a gear check, it's, hey, did you buy every single spell that you can buy? I think Jack's dead. He's dead. Great. Okay. Nice if I knew what order these spells got applied, but just hope for the best that the rough. Okay, good. Good. Okay, now the boss needs to. Okay. Alright, this worked out. Alright. I'm gonna make sure to... Where's my lucky card? There we go. Gonna make sure to use that before this fight's over. Yeah, there... just on the world map, there was a...
Are you fucking kidding me?
Rip the double experience. There was a merchant on the world map that charged like 100 wild arms bucks or something to rename your characters. So to avoid further confusion, I just changed their names back to what they should be. Because even I was getting confused as to what character they were talking about. Dive in anyways? Yep, no more Goro. Canonically, he's only in Shenmue in Grand Stream now. Alright, so we literally Chrono Trigger now. It even looks like the Mammoth Machine. Oh man, hold on. Actually, we'll take this opportunity to use the lucky card right now. Confusion. Yeah, if this boss gave me nothing, I'll be upset.
That damage, though.
Alright, I gotta... Actually, I don't need to heal Rudy. Rudy can just... blast him. Jack and Cecilia. Pretty handy that the one guy who doesn't need to cast spells is the one who's silenced. I'm okay with this. So it appears Cecilia takes like half damage from that spell. I don't need to heal her at the time. That seems okay. Let's protect our allies. Even get a level with our double experience. Humans defeating the defeater. Sure. So the palace is sinking into the ocean, along with Man and Machine. Somebody at Media Vision played Chrono Trigger a few times. Alright, best girl shows up. It isn't over. Well, shit. So we fought a guy with dog before. Siegfried. Alright. This is a warning. We could just kill you all now, but instead we'll wait and fight you all one-on-one. Why fight us when there's five of you there? It'll hunt. Alright. Total annihilate of all life. And tell it to take. Alright, that's pretty good. Do you host me? If you're on PC, there should just be a button directly below the stream that says host. If you're on mobile, you have to tap on the video, tap on the gear icon, and then at the bottom of that thing that comes up should be a host thing. So, apparently I'm supposed to go to the Dragon Sea Shrine. Oh, this is the... That's that vortex thing. Yeah, you could always just type in slash host and then the name, but... Much easier to just hit the button. In most cases. Escape. Alright, I don't think there's any, like, plot mention of needing to go to this shrine, but apparently that's where I have to go next. And there's a boss fight there. The host button's been there for a while. The host thing on mobile is very new. It's like a week old, maybe. But the host button's been there for months, I believe. Alright. We made progress in Wild Arms. We're past the halfway point. I might drop this one because I got permission from Totoro a while ago to drop it. I'll think about it because we're past the halfway point, and as far as I'm concerned, that's... we could read a plot synopsis of what happens. But... oh, it's F-A-Z? Oh, okay. Well, that explains that then. But the official...